I am Christelle. I'm Filipino, but before moving to Sweden, I was living in Hong Kong for 7 years.
Hello, my name is Elina and I'm from Latvia, but before coming to Sweden, I lived in England as well.
Hello, hello, I'm Joanna. I came from Poland and I have been living in Stockholm, Sweden for 1.5 years by now.
Jag heter Alona och jag kommer från Ukraina och jag har bott i Sverige i 3 år och 6 månader.
The reason why I moved to Sweden is because of a job opportunity and I've always wanted to live in Europe and so I thought, why not? I moved here last year during the summer and one of the challenges that I faced is how slow the processes could be in Sweden. It took me 3 months before I could get my personnummer and it's so hard to live in Sweden without a personnummer, which is something that everyone already knows. Another thing, I guess, is the language. I mean, everyone in Sweden can speak English. It's just that the official documents are still in Swedish because English is still not an official language. And so you would still need a basic level of Swedish to be able to get by, in my opinion, and also it's very important for integration. And the last thing for me is the weather. The weather could be very extreme and it gets really dark in the winter. I really struggled with that, and you get to actually adapt to it and find your ways of coping with it, but it's still tough.
The biggest challenge was finding a job. I was struggling so much because I was so focused on the right path, the only one path, and I wish I was working on to becoming a freelancer in much area because I had skills. I just thought I need to find a real job, which made me feel like shit in the end and become depressed and lose a lot in my life. And the best part about Sweden is that I fell in love with sports because I hated sports as a kid, but now I cycle, I roller skate, I do a lot of activities which I never did in my life before. I love sports now, and also ecology, recycling, taking care of my nature around me and all of that, that's thanks to Sweden.
My biggest challenges, I don't really know if there were any. It went very smoothly, actually. First and foremost, thanks to this decision, I could live with my then fiancé and now my beloved husband. Secondly, I could learn myself a new language, one that I like very much, and the fact how quickly were I able to communicate in Swedish really boosted my confidence a lot. A very important and I guess also a life-changing thing is that currently I work a lot to introduce dog frisbee discipline in Sweden. This is a human plus dog sport that is widely known over the world, but for some reason not yet in Sweden. So it's extremely exciting for me and I'm really very positive about the upcoming outcome.
Den största utmaningen för mig var att börja allt från början. När jag flyttade till Sverige bröt pandemin ut, vilket gjorde det svårt att hitta jobb. Därför investerade jag den här tiden i att lära mig svenska och förbättra mina programmeringskunskaper. Så en annan utmaning var bristen på sol under hösten och vinter. Men den positiva aspekten att bo i Sverige skulle jag vilja säga som man sorterar sopor medveten och gör medvetna kläd och matval.
My name is Julia and I come from Ukraine. I've been living in Sweden for the past 3 years. And one of the biggest challenges for me when moving to Sweden was waiting for the personnummer, which is central to all processes here. What truly inspires me about Sweden are its citizens and their dedication to their physical and mental health. Since moving here, I've started trying to find the same balance between work and life. because people here focus on enjoying life rather than constantly chasing after accomplishing as many tasks as possible. So the move to Sweden has been a transformative experience for me, reshaping the way I approach health, work and life in general.
Hi, so I'm Borja, I'm from Spain. I moved here like to Stockholm like 2 years ago, kind of. And the positive or the most difficult things that I would say in Sweden are the winters and the lack of sun because of that. And the positive things, and that would be probably, I mean, the summers are really nice, actually. Now it's June, the temperature is almost perfect. And I would say also the salaries are a bit better than in Spain. And the work-life balance is much, much better here than in the south of Europe.
Hi there, my name is Jessica Hanlon, and I'm an American living in Sweden. I'm originally from Illinois, and I've been living outside of America now for about 15 years. Originally, I lived in Brussels before moving to Stockholm, Sweden. So I have had the opportunity to live in two countries, which is, you know, really a great opportunity to have just to experience different cultures. In Stockholm, I had the challenge of trying to find an apartment in Sweden. And so for me, that was really hard because when we moved here in 2015, it was a pretty hot market and everybody was looking to buy, which is what we were doing. And so when we purchased our apartment, we literally had to look for like 20 apartments and everybody was outbidding everyone, right? So it was just like a big battle. And I found that to be a really big challenge when I was trying to buy an apartment here. And then there were other challenges, of course. I mean, there's the language barrier that you have. And depending if you move with, if you're moving to Sweden with somebody who speaks the language, that makes it so much easier. So my husband is Swedish, and so navigating the system here was a lot easier. That was kind of a challenge, just trying to understand what things meant. Just, you know, going to SFE was another challenge, trying to learn the language, because there were other people who were also from other countries that didn't even speak English. So that for me was a little bit of a challenge. And I also didn't really learn Swedish the same way as like other people did. So I had to basically go on my own and learn Swedish just by hearing it and being around people. Also a challenge is making new friends, and making friends in another country can be kind of difficult because you don't know where they're hanging out, right? And when you're with with kids, it makes it harder just to go out and be social. And so I joined different Facebook groups and networking events so that I could meet people. And that was really great because I made friends with lots of other expats that, you know, are not Swedish, but I also made friends with other Swedes. So, you know, you just have to put yourself out there if you are moving to a new country. Starting a business in another country was also quite difficult. I'm a photographer and I had to basically understand how accounting works, how the business side works here in Sweden. There were different challenges that I experienced as personal and then professional as well, but just even living abroad has been a wonderful experience because I was able to, you know, just live a different lifestyle than most people. And I think that just embracing the difference, the hardships, and just, you know, navigating life and enjoying it is the only way to make it through living abroad. So yeah, those are the challenges that I experienced, but just having a really positive mindset about everything can really help you to navigate your new life abroad.